directly transaction looks for, or should I just skip all of that stuff? You can skip it? Okay, what's next on the list? Should I talk about things that they don't normally tell you in the real estate business? Right? Because it's, you know, not all nice and pleasant, and you know, not everyone is good in the business. There's a lot of bad people, dishonest people, nasty people, disgusting people in the business, people who, you know, screw you, try to, you know, take advantage of you, right? Especially when you're starting off, right? They really take advantage of you, right? So when I started off in 2012, right, you know, I didn't enter the real estate business not knowing absolutely nothing. I actually did have a fair amount of knowledge when it came to construction, because I was building houses with Habitat for Humanity, right? So I had a fair amount of knowledge how houses was built. So if someone told me about, you know, how you fix something, I get it, right? So it's not like I was going in with no knowledge at all, right? So in the real estate business, you have some of the professionals who, you know, when it comes to getting a deal done, some of the professionals you have real estate agents, you have no one comes in the front for except Roshni. Roshni is the bravest. So you have real estate agents, you have real estate lawyers, you have real estate accountants, you have mortgage brokers, you have appraisers, home inspectors, contractors, stagers, anything you can think about, right? But for simplicity, right, in a real estate transaction, you have buyers and sellers, right? And then agents have to represent each of them. You must need a lawyer to represent on each side when it comes to closing a deal, right? And if you are the buyer, I mean, you need a mortgage broker, hopefully with an investor's mindset, if it is an investment property that it is you're getting. So the things they don't normally tell you in the real estate business is, you know, everyone is out to make money. They're all in it to make money, right? No one, you have to think of it, you have to go in with this mindset when you are starting off or you're investing. You can't trust anybody, right? That was the advice that I received from day one, and you know, I still ended up getting screwed, right? Making mistakes. Maybe they say, oh, this guy is looking all young, handsome, and he's looking, you know, let's stiff this guy. That's what happened, right? For people who've been in the business for a few years. So they're all in it to make money, right? You really can't trust anybody. The real estate agent, right, unless it is a real estate agent who does not need income or does not need money, right? You know, and is actually truly helping you, right, to succeed, right? And help you build your own real estate empire, helping you get started with the first property the right way, right? And helping you, you know, guiding you along the way, right, to really be in your best interest, right? Most real estate agents, they are not like that, right? They need commission. Is anyone a real estate agent in this? Okay, so sorry. But I'm just, you probably have come across some real estate agents.
Yes, sir.
Well,
nobody works for free, do you?
No one works for free, right? But hopefully, you know, you don't undervalue yourself and you're a 1% commission real estate agent, right? So big difference, right, when you deal with a 1% commission real estate agent versus someone who is 2.5, right? So what I'm trying to say is, right, you have agents who are not really specializing in when it comes to investment properties. They don't even invest in properties or own investment properties themselves, but they say they are a real estate expert when it comes to investment properties, right? So the best thing when you're starting off and you're building your portfolio, right, instead of the first thing you ask them, show me what it is you have done. You know, everyone is great at just talking. But again, remember, when you are starting off, the first thing you ask is, the first thing you have to be, the mindset is you can't trust anybody in the business.
Right.
So you have to, you know, when it comes to the education, right, read as much, learn as much, so the more knowledgeable you are, right, the other guy can't screw you, right, or the other person, right? So when it comes to people referring to other people, given that they are not a good person, right, and probably from past experiences, or probably from just first meeting with the person, right? And if you have good instincts or gut feeling, right, then you could probably tell that guy or that person smells a bit fishy, right? And that person, you know, probably is not someone you would want to deal with. You don't feel that sort of level of trust with someone, right? Go with your gut feeling. Right. So pretty much you have buyer, seller, real estate agents, lawyers, mortgage broker, right? So let's start with those five.